This is Al Takatsch with Jefferson ClockWorks, and we're back to show you the next clock on the bench. This happens to be a Korean clock. It says 35 day on the front. On first inspection, the crutch, which drives the pendulum, a little piece of paper stuck in here. Okay, that's loose. I'm going to take the movement out now, lay it on the workbench, get rid of the case. I'll be right back. Don't forget to have one of these little a sandwich meat or potato salad containers, like from the supermarket. They make a great place to put all of your parts into, and make it big enough so it doesn't flip over on its own. And that will really save the day, because especially if you drop some screws on the floor, you may not find them. After you get the mainspring clamps on, and the unit will look like this. I put the levers back on there so you could see how easy it is to take these off. I have this parts rack that I made from an A-frame from Staples that secretaries use to hold up papers, and I had bent it in strategic places and reinforced it with some tire wraps. I'm going to be using my lathe for polishing the pivots now, and you can use a hand drill if you wish that has a variable speed and a locking trigger. So, and you can mount that in like a wood vise or some type of vise that holds it horizontally. As you can see, this piece right here, I got this off of a drill press, a hand drill myself. The hand drill went bad, the motor and the batteries, so I threw those away and I took the Jacobs chuck off, and then I just simply bought an adapter from Tag, who makes this lathe, and this way I can use the lathe to spin the arbors. And so I'll be right back. Alright, I got it up on the test stand. I used the flat one with the V on top as well as on the bottom. Hopefully the pendulum has got enough place to swing here, in case we put this on there. And it looks like it does. If you use one of these guys, make sure that the Y part of the feet are spread equally left and right, so it gives you the most amount of room for a long pendulum like what we got here. So that's all she wrote for this repair. We're pretty much done here. I hope your repair turned out the same way. This is Al Takatsch with Jefferson ClockWorks, and we'll see you at the next clock. Thanks for watching.